In this problem, we're asked to determine the value of b and c for a quadratic function that has a vertex with an x-coordinate of 3 and a y-coordinate of negative 17. So looking at our function again, notice that a, the leading coefficient, is equal to negative 2, and then we're asked to determine the value of b and the value of c. If we look at the graph of a quadratic function just for a moment, we should know the equation for the axis of symmetry is x equals negative b divided by 2a when our function is written in general form here. Well, the vertex, or this point here, is the only point that's on the parabola, or the graph of our function, and the axis of symmetry. Therefore, the x-coordinate of the vertex is equal to negative b divided by 2a, the same formula used to determine the equation of the axis of symmetry, and then the y-coordinate of the vertex, because it's on the function, would have to be f of negative b divided by 2a. We can use this information to solve this given problem. So if we start with the equation of the axis of symmetry, which also gives us the x-coordinate of the vertex. So because the x-coordinate of our vertex is 3, this x must equal 3, and this must equal negative b divided by 2 times a, and we know a is negative 2. So here we would have 3 equals, this would be negative b divided by negative 4. Well, a negative divided by a negative is positive, so we have b divided by 4. Now multiplying both sides by 4, we can see that b must equal positive 12. Let's go ahead and record this. We know b is 12. Now going back to our vertex, notice when x is 3, y is equal to negative 17, which means if we evaluate our function or determine f of 3, it must equal negative 17. So f of 3 is going to be equal to negative 2 times 3 squared. We know b is 12, so we'd have plus 12 times 3 plus c, and we know this must equal negative 17. And now we'll solve this for c. So 3 squared is 9 times negative 2, that's negative 18, plus 12 times 3 is 36, plus c equals negative 17. Combining like terms, this would be 18 plus c equals negative 17. And finally subtracting 18 on both sides, we have c equals negative 35. So if c is equal to negative 35, we now know our quadratic function. It is f of x equals negative 2x squared plus 12x minus 35. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful.